In this demonstration, we will use NX advanced durability to evaluate the fatigue life of a muffler under various loading conditions represented by transient and static solutions. NX-NASTRAN will be used to determine the stresses and strains in the muffler. Fatigue life will be computed using both low cycle and high cycle approaches. Let's begin by going to the FEM level to examine our material properties. Durability requires a definition of specific fatigue material properties. You'll notice in the strength tab, definition of yield strength values and ultimate tensile strength. These are going to be used by advanced durability to evaluate the static strength safety factors and margins of safety. In the durability formability tab, we have both fatigue strength and fatigue ductility, coefficients and exponents. In the cyclic parameters group, we have yield strength, strength coefficient, and strength hardening exponents. These values will be used to convert between stress cycles and strain cycles while computing fatigue damage. Now we're ready to move on to the sim level. We can begin by examining both solutions. We have a static SOL 101 solution and a response sim 103. Let's begin by looking at the 101. We're interested in the stresses of low speed case 3. You can see that these stresses are higher than the strength of the material. Looking at solution 103, we have an enforced motion displacement at the center node and excitation of displacement versus time at this node. We can notice that these stresses are on average much lower than the material yield strength. Therefore, after examining these stresses, we can determine that a different fatigue life approach will be used for each case. The strain life approach is chosen when defining the static durability event based on the static solution. And a stress life approach is chosen for the transient event that will point to the response simulation solution. We are now ready to define our new solution process. You'll notice that we have the choice to define both a static and a transient durability process. We will first create a static event by selecting the static NASTRAN solution and then superimpose an excitation load pattern. We will go through these tabs to define the event. In the strength tab, we'll define our stress criterion and our strength outputs, which includes margins of safety and safety factors. To validate the durability of the muffler in the fatigue tab, you can choose the life criterion and define some extra outputs such as event damage and failure indices. In the stress axes tab, we have the power to dictate the locations and directions for the stress and strain histories used in the durability fatigue computations. These methods define how the software will find the critical loading path of the structure and how it will determine the most likely direction along which cracks would form and propagate. And lastly, in the solve options, we can validate the elements to be analyzed. We will now add an excitation to our static event, and it will be based on subcase 3. We will also choose to use a full unit cycle, which means that we will get a fully reversed loading pattern. You have the possibility to scale the loading amplitude by a multiplication factor. You can also apply a stress offset so that the mean stress is not zero. At this point, you can either solve or add more static or transient events to the analysis. We will now add a transient event to the durability analysis. This will be based on the results from the response simulation solution that was created earlier. In the fatigue tab, we will define a stress life approach. The stress axes tab will choose some options that were explained earlier. And the new tab, data control, you have some new options such as output start and end time. This can be used to evaluate fatigue over only a portion of your transient solution time domain. And lastly, in the solve options, we will analyze the transient event on a group of elements. We have completed the transient event setup. Note that since the durability product is fully integrated in NX, you can at any time go back to edit these events. This advantage avoids time-consuming back-and-forth transactions with other programs. We will now solve the durability solution process. This will extract worst-case static and fatigue strength results for both events, and will accumulate the fatigue damage from both events and compute the associated accumulated life. If desired, you also have the option to solve only one event at a time. Once the solution is complete, we can examine the results using the full suite of NX post-processing tools. We can inspect the accumulated effect of all the events. We can also examine the contribution of each event to the total fatigue resistance of the component. After examining the fatigue results, we may want to modify the design to test a what-if scenario. We can now edit the durability solution process and apply material override on the group of elements in the transient event. We can easily rerun this event only and examine our new results. We can see that although the maximum indices are lower, some are still above one. Therefore, further analysis and design changes will be required. This concludes our demonstration of NX Advanced Durability.